So you have to have a host organization that is really coordinating it with TI. It's really, the reason for a gavel club is to make it for individuals who are not eligible for a Toastmaster. So really anybody over 18 can join Toastmasters typically. So what I have found is that gavel clubs are usually for people who are under 18 or people in prison. Okay, there are a number, from what I've heard, a number of prison gavel clubs. And you can understand that that would be kind of a neat thing, you know, to do that. Also, gavel clubs are not assigned to any district. If you help start a gavel club, you don't really get any formal credit towards doing that for TI, although I must think that forming a gavel club would be a great high performance leadership project. You know, I mean, to me, that would fit in very nicely. The note that Toastmasters gives is that gavel clubs have limited access to the leadership track, awards materials, they can't be in speech contests and things like that. So again, it's a sort of a self-contained club, but it operates very much like a Toastmasters club, just for that unique group of people. It really is easy to get started. The sponsoring organization, all they need to do is apply with TI. The application fee is $50, and then their annual fee is $48. It's paid once a year, and it's prorated, so it's about $4 a month. So if you start in the middle of the year, it's $24. And the other thing is you don't have to have 20 members to start. You can start with any number of members. You don't have to start with 20 members to do that. And then you can buy other materials. So typically in our situation, we have, as I mentioned, the Finn Scaffold Club, sponsored by the family instructors of the North Suburbs. That's a homeschool cooperative. We started with 15 members in 2004. Now a parent is the coordinator of the group, and I am the mentor for the club. So we worked it so that we meet twice monthly. My Toastmaster meetings are on the first, third, and fifth Thursday. We arrange the gavel club on the second and fourth Thursdays of the month. And we run them for 90 minutes. Officers, we elect a full slate of officers for 6 months. Students start with the CC manuals, and the meetings go almost exactly like a normal Toastmasters meeting. The only difference would be at the end, I would typically get up and, you know, kind of critique it, tell them how good they did, give them little tips and techniques, that kind of stuff. A couple times when I was out of town for work, Linda stepped in and helped and did a great job for that. We appreciated Linda's efforts. But again, there's the big brief business meeting, the prepared speeches, evaluation table topics, VP of education gets up and makes sure the agenda's set for the 2 weeks following. Also, all speakers know at least 2 meetings in advance. We went ahead and were able to move to the CCA North Campus. Currently we have 21 members. Several of our members already have their CCs. I have one young student who is working on his third advanced manual. I'll tell you very briefly, I'll talk about some of the kids that we work with. They don't use the leadership manual. We don't use it. They give it to us, but we started to use it in the beginning. It just got too complicated, so we kind of canned that. One thing that I have found is that some of our students also take, even though they're in high school, they take classes at CCAC. So they're earning college credit while they're still in high school. And some of them come out of high school and our room, our conference room, we have state-of-the-art conference room at CCAC. This one young gentleman here in the this is Thomas's brother. I mentioned Thomas before. This is Joseph, who started with us back in 14. Also, this is Joseph, who is first chair of the Youth Symphony, and he is. I attended one of their concerts last year, and he is just an amazing, amazing violinist. I mean, he could be world class at some point. A great young kid. Also, this is Calvin. He was one of our first oldest students. He just graduated a couple weeks ago from CMU. He's going on to grad school. This young man is David. He is at Penn State right now. He's doing great. Here is Mary. Mary's going to a small school in Vermont. Mary actually, four of her older siblings were at one time members of our club, and we're very close to that family. This is David. He just graduated. He's going to Slipperbuck. This is Micah, who is going to Robert Morris. He got a full scholarship to Robert Morris. He's going in as a sophomore. Also, at the same time he's graduating from high school, he graduated from at community college with an associate's degree. And this, another one of our members, I don't have his picture here, is Anthony. He started a company called Bubble Ball of Pittsburgh, and they set up things for birthdays and stuff. I mean, these are just great kids. I mean, I just love working. One other youth opportunity that we're going to really touch on. Did anybody know what these are? Merit badges. Boy and Girl Scout merit badges. We were contacted by a Girl Scout troop, and we talked to them about youth leadership. That didn't work for them. So what we did is Linda and I began the conversation. So, well, how can we help these girls get their badges? So they gave us information about what they need to do. So what we did is we created a one-night agenda for the Girl Scouts. We basically gave them homework to prepare an icebreaker, to give the teen speech a title, give an introduction for us, and then a few weeks later we held a one evening session at their church. We gave them a general introduction to public speaking. We brought in Missy, who I mentioned earlier. She was a younger female, and she really related to the students. We had a 2 to 3 minute, each of the Girl Scouts had a 2 to 3 minute icebreaker. We had round robin evaluation, impromptu speaking, and a summary. And in that one fell swoop, we helped, probably 12 to 15 girls get their icebreakers pinned. And it was a truncated version of what we do and how we do it, but at least it gave them that feeling. And we could tell that some of the girls were getting over their nervousness, at least in getting up in front of the group and doing that. So that's pretty much our workshop. Let me give you, if you want, we have some handouts that we'll make available for you as you leave. General information on the youth leadership program. We also have a truncated summary of the 8 sessions. We have information on the Gavel Club and the agenda for the merit badge program. Yes, how can I help?
Couple questions. One, 8 meetings for youth leadership program. How many of the 8 do the youth need to attend to get credit? How many of the 8 programs? If they come to 6, if they come to 7, if they come to 5, what's your rule of thumb on it?
Well, the credit is for.
Oh, not you. I'm saying different. I'm not saying the formal Toastmasters credit. Just like, is there a when you get there, is there participation certificates? It's like if they show up to 2 of 8 meetings,
To be honest, I'm not sure, because we had pretty much 100% participation. discussed that, to be honest with you.
That's one thing, if like, you know, if you're homeschooling, the parents are bringing them to meet, that's one thing, but if, like, yeah, in a neighborhood youth nonprofit, and the kids are walking themselves, so it's,
yeah,
it's,
yeah,
much more independent drive, so,
yeah,
you can't,
yeah,
except for the kids themselves, so, I mean, it's fine, so, you know, yeah. And then for youth leadership program and gavel clubs, how many Toastmasters members do you need to have to involve in each of them?
Well, we found that the best, two Toastmasters can get credit for a single youth leadership program, an 8-week program, or a session program. And what we did is we paired off, so we would do, you know, one Toastmaster would kind of coordinate and work on the most of the items for one, and so we would kind of make, you know, go half and half pretty much to create that synergy. So yeah, I mean, and we did that. We always had at least two people, sometimes three Toastmasters at every meeting, and usually we would have a handful of parents who would sit in and listen to it. And we still have a number of parents who will come and sit in on the gavel club meetings every week or every other week. Yeah, Jeff.
Did the Girl Scouts tell you why they were interested in youth leadership programs? Boy Scout Council. There are several merit badges that fit in.
Yeah.
Well,
again, it was a matter of, you know, I don't think they wanted to have 8 continuous meetings of their meetings. I didn't think they also wanted to have, another meeting other than their regular troop meeting. So that's pretty much what we found. But they were interested in getting help with that particular badge. And again, there could be leadership badges or other badges.
I know there's communications badges.
Yeah, we can work with the badges. Okay. We're going to have to wrap up pretty quick. Yeah. So, you had a question.
Yeah, for you, I know you said that the parents attended, like, the last meeting anyhow, when you had the youth leadership.
Yeah, we brought them all together.
Were you able to pull any parents into a Toastmaster club?
To be honest, we mentioned that at the very end, but no, we did not end up with any parents in the thing. Chang Bao.
How many speeches can each student give in the youth program?
Typically they would give at least 2, some of them gave 3 in that 8-week period. And Betsy?
I wanted to clarify about the credit question. I don't remember, Rick, that we formulated it as though we were giving those students formal credit for anything. So it would have been up to their parents, but I don't think in this case they did. If there were credit given, I would think that it would come from, that decision would be made by whoever the organizing group would be.
Yeah.
We didn't do that.
Well, I had that same question. I think, you know, when you said they get a certificate at the end, mm-hmm. the group I'm thinking about, you know, there are so many kids who are going to miss, just like in our Toastmasters meetings, people miss. Mm-hmm. So they miss like one of the things, they still get a certificate at the end. So that's what I was, not necessarily credit for anything, but just have they successfully completed the program.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
If they miss 1 or 2.
Well, I mean, that would give us
a
point.
So that's up to, okay.
Yeah,
so just
like,
yeah,
that's right. Okay.
And they're an officer for what, half the time. So,
yeah.
But,
yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
There might be a meeting where they're not giving a speech or.
Right. Yeah, but again, we try to make sure that they get involved both in the communication and the leadership parts, running the meeting, doing everything that we would do, that we try to do in a normal Toastmaster setting. Any other questions? I'll leave some handouts right over here, and I certainly thank you for your participation.